A high-ranking Lawrence County deputy is out of a job tonight. Captain Michael Thomason was arrested during an undercover sexting in Greenville County. News 4's Angela Rodriguez joins us live and local outside the Greenville County Detention Center, and she has the latest. Angela, he's accused of making sexual advances toward another male deputy?
That's right, Carol. There was apparently no mention of having sex, but according to the incident report, Thomason touched the undercover deputy's private part.
This Berea shopping center off Whitehorse Road has a laundromat, restaurants, and an adult store, but the parking lot has quite a reputation.
The sheriff's office had been receiving several citizen complaints from the area that there was inappropriate sexual activity going on.
It's a known hotspot where men come to pick up other men. The ongoing complaints led to an undercover sexting Friday night. The only person arrested, though, was Lawrence County Captain Michael Thomason. Investigators say the veteran officer drove his county-issued vehicle to the shopping center. Thomason was seen coming out of the Video Magic store, and then he allegedly approached an undercover deputy sitting in an unmarked car.
Mr. Thomason, while he was in the car with our undercover deputy, started doing some sexually explicit things to himself, and then he grabbed our deputy, our undercover deputy. At that point, our deputy placed him under arrest.
Thomason is now charged with assault and battery in the second degree and loitering to engage in sexual activity. The Lawrence County Sheriff's Office confirms the captain was fired on Saturday. Thomason was with the force for 12 years.
You know, when we do these undercover operations, we have no idea who we're going to encounter. And it just so happens, unfortunately, this was a deputy from another agency.
Greenville County hopes the sexting sends a message. Shopping for sex here will get you arrested. Investigators are watching, even if you don't see them.
Thomason has bonded out of jail. He's set to appear in court on September 27th, and if convicted, we're told he could face up to 3 years in prison. And because he's accused of touching another man's private parts, a judge could require him to register as a sex offender. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Greenville.